This is Too Many DJs present 2x2.
Beats 1.
Hello, this is Too Many DJs. Actually, I'm not Too Many DJs. I'm just a voice speaking on their behalf. I've never met them, and I'm merely saying what they're feeding me. This is the second in a series of shows we're doing exclusively for Beats 1, called
2x2.
2x2.
A 2-hour-long trip.
The first hour includes a number of new exclusive remixes and edits by us that have not been released yet, mixed with just good new music by Tiga,
Factory Floor,
Paranoid London,
and many more. Plus, we're premiering a new track on our label Dewey. We're also going to visit the Bahamas in the second hour, as we're giving you our tribute to the legendary Compass Point Studios, so stay tuned for that. First, though, we're going to kick off this hour with one of our favourite records of the year by Bullion. Here is our remix for It's No Spirit. Just made for Monica. We've never met her, but apparently this song was a huge hit in Greece. It's Secret in the Dark.
Too Many DJs.
We'll be right back.
DJs.
2x2, beats one.
Voilà. Voilà.
Gonzalez by Voila. And up next in the mix is the Alessandro Adriani remix of The Greatest Name That Lives by Lata Amasa, a Hindustani singer from New York that released this track originally in 1980 and is one of our favorite records of the moment.
This is Too Many DJs present 2x2.
Beats 1.
Listening to 2x2 with Too Many DJs. Coming up is our edit for a track called Pump Up the Leads to Red, Take Some Drugs and Shake Your Head by Aqua Regia. And after that, some Paranoid London. So stay tuned.
Too Many DJs in the mix.
This is their soon-to-be-released track, Volume. It will be DWE 018. Don't go away.
Too many DJs on Beats One.
Thank you.
Hey everyone, don't worry. This is still 2x2 on Beats 1. We have to be honest, we have no idea who made this piece of music, as it just says untitled on the vinyl. So if this is your record, please come forward. From Munich.
And coming up is a great edit by our friends of Inflagranti in the Spiritus Rectus series, a staple in our DJ sets.
We'll be right back. is Too Many DJs in the mix.
Beats One.
Made by Ivan Smarg of Civil Defense by Alias. A track we love to play out at
Dispatchio.
And after that, we'll be playing some Factory Floor off their new album. Is a track by our new favourite band called Nice as Fudge. Or maybe they're called Nice as Frig, we're not sure.
No tears!
DJs.
2x2 Beats 1.
Be careful where you park your car. There's no telling what she might do. Cause she never had the chance to hurt you too. And if you're asking why, if you're asking why, you looked a little too pleased when you saw.
We're so in awe of his talent and prolific output, and his music always brings a smile to our faces. Before that, we had a track off the brilliant new album by Cat's Eyes. You should also check out the soundtrack they made for the great film called The Duke of Burgundy last year. So up next, we have another new remix we made for Shock Machine. His album is highly anticipated, and this is possibly our favourite track off it. Open Up the Sky. We highly recommend checking it out. He also makes his own wine.
Open up the sky.
approaching the end of the first hour, but please don't go away, as we'll be taking you to the Bahamas in the next hour, in our ode to Chris Blackwell and his Compass Point Studios. Welcome back to the second hour of 2x2 with Too Many DJs, Episode 2. This hour is very dear to our hearts, as it's our tribute to one of the most legendary recording studios, Compass Point in Nassau in the Bahamas. This was not just any ordinary recording studio. It was a powerhouse of creativity, where some of our favourite records were made. Fueled by its founder, Chris Blackwell, the owner of Island Records, and, in our eyes, a true genius. He had a secret dream to build a distinctive studio of his own. A giant blank canvas for audio. A space where music could be made without the distraction of external influence. The tracks we're about to play in this mix are all either recorded, produced, or mixed at Compass Point. And even though not every song adheres to this rule, and are just recorded there by bands visiting the studio, the majority of them are played or affected by the hands of the nucleus of what would be known as the Compass Point All-Stars. A recording band that Visionary Blackwell put together in 1980, based on a Jamaican reggae foundation shaped around legendary combo Sly and Robbie. With Sly Dunbar on drums and Robbie Shakespeare on bass, Mikey Chung on guitar, Sticky Isaiah Thompson on percussion, and augmented with a European influence of Barry Reynolds on guitar and Wally Badaru on keyboards. They provided the backbone to many of the sessions where artists had flown out to the Bahamas. Chris Blackwell himself said, "I wanted a new, progressive-sounding band. A Jamaican rhythm section with an edgy mid-range and a brilliant synth player. And I got what I wanted, fortunately." Apart from the musicians and Blackwell himself, the Compass Point core personnel also included Alex Sadkin and Stephen Sanley on producer and engineering duty. And to us, this nucleus of people was very influential in teaching us that a recording studio and its players can be used as a creative tool for making music, something that inspired us to build our own DE studio.
You are an important person, a rare individual, a unique creature. There has never been anyone just like you, and never will be. You have talents and abilities no one else has. In some ways, you're superior to any other living person. The power to do anything you can imagine is within you. When you discover your real self by practicing a few simple laws of success.
First law of
Take inventory of your assets. Don't be modest or critical. Be open and objective. Get a pencil and paper. Write down every good thing about yourself you can think of.
It's you.
Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen.
It's you.
Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen.
It's you.
Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen. Make it happen.
Amazing Will Powers, a sort of anomaly of a record made by photographer Lynn Goldsmith, who on one of her many visits to Compass Point to take pictures happened to be around when neither Marianne Faithfull nor Joe Cocker managed to please Robert Palmer by singing on one of his demos and in a drunken state decided to make her own record under the moniker Will Powers on Palmer's backing track.
Great records made at Compass Point that we didn't manage to squeeze in here. So, if anything, please let this mix inspire you to discover them for yourself.
At Compass Point,
which is not easy to fit in only 1 hour.
And we tried to focus mainly on the aforementioned all-stars and Compass Point family, like
Bits and Pieces,
Chris Blackwell on Grace Jones's album, where he and Barry Reynolds were used to supply a European edge to the Jamaican reggae-based backing band. And from there, the Compass Point All-Stars gradually became one of the most influential formations. And Wally's solo albums, recorded at Compass Point, still sound futuristic and are to this day still sampled to death. Believe it or not, but this is the Thompson Twins with Nurse Shark, a B-side they made at Compass Point.
Thank you.
When people think of Compass Point, they'll also think of Grace Jones and the records she made with the dream team of the All Stars and Chris Blackwell. But one other band that would prove to have a long history at the studio was Talking Heads from New York, who really made full use of the facilities, and whose rhythm section would become an extension of the larger family at Compass Point.
Mm-hmm.
Jones, perhaps one of the quintessential Compass Point All-Star recordings. And up next is a little section of a Roxy Music track recorded at Compass Point.
Beats one.
Too many DJs.
The amazing Stephen Stanley, using the studio as an instrument here under the moniker of Bits and Pieces, with the track Trouble in Bass. We'll be right back. was Peanut Butter by Gwen Guthrie, with The Usual Suspects as backing band. A Compass Point classic here on Beats One with Too Many DJs. And up next is Ian Dury with Spasticus Autisticus.
I'm spasticus, autisticus.
So place your heart and peanuts in my tin, and thank the creator, you're not in the state I'm in. So long have I been languished on the shelf, I must give all proceedings to myself.
Get to this.
That was Get to This by Sly and Robbie. You're still listening to Beats One. And this Robert Palmer Pride Dub is a good example of how the studio was used by the Compass Point All-Stars to push the boundaries on where pop music, dub and disco managed to blend.
Too many DJs.
2x2, Beats One.
Neighborhood.
Wordy Rapping Hood, one of the quintessential Compass Point recordings for us, and possibly one of the most important tracks of our youth by Tom Tom Club. The band founded by Tina Weymouth and Chris France. The rhythm section of the aforementioned Talking Heads, who are up next with the demo for one of their most well-known songs.
With a beautiful wife, and you may ask yourself, well, how did I get here?
was Joe Cocker's backing band, the All Stars.
In the mix here at Beats One.
And up next is one of the key players, Barry Reynolds, who played on so many other recordings on this hour as a solo artist with his version of I Scare Myself. You're still listening to Too Many DJs on Apple Music's Beats One. Jones's amazing vocals, all the brainchild of Chris Blackwell at Compass Point.
Strange, I've seen that face before. Seen him hanging around my door like a hawk stealing for the prey. Night and night, waiting for the day. Dans sa chambre, Joël et sa valise. On regarde sur ses fringues, sur les murs de photos, sans regret, sans mélo. La porte est claquée, Joël est barré.
Coming to One of the key Compass Point players is definitely Robert Palmer, who remains undervalued in our opinion, and was actually a neighbour of the studio and signed to Island Records. So naturally he was a Compass Point regular and was always hanging out.
Sound of the telephone. Oh yeah.
our show. And we do so with a band that would maybe not be considered as typical Compass Point, but who were nonetheless a huge part of the story. They were introduced to Chris Blackwell by Talking Heads and recorded some of their best music and possibly some of our favourite music in the Bahamas. We thank you all for coming on this journey with us and hope this inspires you to venture out and seek out your own Compass Point favourites. There are many more we could fit into this mix.
Apple Music.
This is Too Many DJs, present 2x2.
Beats 1.